So here we have the fully completed PCR for Chewyeezy's peanut preparation department. And in this, we found out that once we were done doing all of our calculations for our equivalent units and assigning costs and all of that fun stuff, that out of the $208,000 worth of total costs, which we did account for, $176,000 is getting transferred to the next phase of production, while $32,000 is staying within the peanut preparation department as that department's contribution towards our ending WIP. So what is, in this case, our second phase of production? Well, that's when we're going to jar the peanut butter. And when we jar the peanut butter, we have a new set of direct materials that would go in, the jars, the lids, any additives. They put a chemical in peanut butter to stop it from separating so you don't get a bunch of gnarly liquid up on the top. Things like that. That would be the direct material costs that go in to the jarring process, our second and final phase of production. All these things are still done by machines, so we would have workers who have to operate the machines that grind the properly prepared peanuts to be used as peanut butter, as well as the jars that are the machines that add all the additives that are needed, and finally the machines that end up jarring the peanut butter into sellable finished condition. All of those machines are going to depreciate, they're going to need maintenance, so that can be part of our manufacturing overhead. We could have some indirect materials and indirect labor up in there, and we'll have to assign a portion of our rent, insurance, supervisor salaries, all of that sort of stuff. So there is manufacturing overhead costs that are unique to this department. But when we figure out what the costs are for this department, we're going to use the same process. We're once again going to make a PCR. And to do so, we're going to need the same information for the jarring department that we had for the peanut preparation department. We need information in terms of the physical units that came through this department, as well as their costs. And just like before, we know how many cases worth of peanut butter jars were in beginning WIP when the period ended. We know how many new cases were transferred and started in production in this department, which is 40,000, which you should note is also equal to the number of physical units which were transferred out of the peanut preparation department during the period. Makes sense. The new units in the second phase of production should be equal to the number of units that came out of the first phase of production. And all in all, we know that we transferred out, and since the last phase of production, we finished 38,000 cases worth of peanut butter during this month. We'll figure out how many units in our ending WIP when we do our calculations, but we know that those units in ending WIP, those cases worth of peanut butter jars we're working on, are only 20% complete for materials and 30% complete for conversion costs. For the units that we have in beginning WIP, they already had $22,000 worth of costs committed to them, which were transferred in from the previous department, from the peanut preparation department. And the jarring department to those units that are in beginning WIP had already added $1,000 worth of material costs and $1,200 worth of conversion costs to the units that we were working on at the start of July. Over here, for our direct materials that got added and our conversion costs got added, we know how much we spent in material costs and combined labor and overhead costs on units that we worked on in the jarring department during the period. So this isn't the total cost of all of the units thus far, it's only the costs that were added by this jarring department, the cost of lids and jars and labor for the people that work in this department, etc. Costs unique to this second phase of production. And we're once again going to make a PCR, and it's the exact same process, but now since we're not the first phase of production, we're the second phase, we're going to have a new column, which is the transferred in column. And that represents the cost of, in this case, all of the costs that were transferred in from the peanut preparation department. If you have a production process that's 3, 4, 5 steps long, it'll be the cost of all of the stuff that had happened before it made it to your department. But the process for doing it is exactly the same. Start with how many physical units you have, figuring out how many you had in beginning WIP when the period ended, and for Chewyeezy, that was 5,000, given in the information. How many got transferred in during the period? We know already that 40,000 cases worth of peanuts were transferred to the jarring department during this month of July. So all in all, the jarring department has to account for 45,000 cases worth of peanuts. Where did they end up at? How many of those 45,000 cases worth of peanuts did we actually make into peanut butter and jar and have in a sellable finished condition? Well, we transferred out 38,000. That's the number of jars that would have went to finished goods since we're the last phase of production. during the period. So if we had 45,000 cases worth of peanuts at all points during this month of July, and only 38,000 got transferred out, the other 7,000 have to be in our ending WIP. But we accounted for our 45,000 cases of peanut butter. Let's do our equivalent unit calculations for now transferred in costs, direct material costs you need to the jarring department, and conversion costs you need to the jarring department. For transferred in, it's going to be the same, because all of these cases that are in ending WIP, all of the cases that we transferred off to finished goods, they had to have had all of the costs committed to them from the departments, the phases of production that came before us. So transferred in's number of equivalent units is always going to be the same as physical units, because they would not be in this department if they weren't complete for all of the stuff from the departments which transferred them in to the jarring department. As per direct materials, but the units that got completed and transferred out had to be done for all of the costs that were unique to the jarring department, or we wouldn't have transferred them off to finished goods to be sold. But the units that are in ending WIP might not be complete for materials. They might not all be sitting in jars and have an aluminum seal on them and have the lid, etc. In fact, we know up here that they are only 20% done for all the material costs that are unique to the jarring department. So what I can do is I can take the number of physical units. We know we have 7,000 cases worth of peanuts sitting in here. Multiply them by how complete they are. They're 20% done for material costs. That comes out to 1,400. For the same amount of cost that it cost us to complete 7,000 cases of peanut butter 20% of the way, we could have fully completed 1,400 cases from start to finish. So my total units accounted for, my total equivalent units for direct materials, is 39,400. Total amount of direct material costs that get spent that are unique to this department should be enough to complete 39,400 cases of peanut butter from start to finish. For a conversion cost, for completed and transferred out, same concept applies. We would not have transferred these off to finished goods if we had not incurred all the overhead costs and paid all the labor costs necessary to take these now properly prepared peanuts that came into us from the first department and put them into jars that can actually be sold. So the completed and transferred out row is just going to be the same number all the way across, because all if they're getting transferred out, all of those units have to be 100% complete for those cost components. But for ending WIP, let's follow that same process that we did before. Take the number of physical units that you had. We have 7,000 cases in ending WIP. Multiply them by how done they are for, in this case, conversion cost, which is 30%, and you get 2,100. For the same exact cost that we paid to convert 7,000 units 30% of the way, we could have finished 2,100 cases from start to finish. And therefore, my total equivalent units that I have accounted for conversion costs is 40,100. And again, for these numbers right here, when we use equivalent units of production in our calculations on the bottom half of this PCR, those are the figures that we're going to use. So moving on to the cost section, the bottom half of our PCR, let's start with transferred in costs. Our units, which were in beginning WIP, already had $22,000 worth of cost in them, which were transferred in from the peanut preparation department. And then during the period, what amount of costs were added to us? And if you'll recall, back on the peanut preparation department's PCR, we broke down the total amount of cost at the end that should be transferred out versus what should stay in their ending WIP. And the cost that was being transferred out was $176,000. Well, if it's getting transferred out of the first phase of production, it's getting transferred into the second phase of production. So always find the department or the phase that is before the one that you're doing the PCR for. Whatever is getting transferred out of that first process, this has to be what's getting transferred in to the second process. So all in all, the peanut preparation department added $198,000, the sum of those two numbers, to the jars of peanut butter, which we were working on at all points during this month of July. Now let's divide that by our equivalent units of production, which we figured out above was 45,000. And we get $4.40. Every case of peanut butter that comes in to the jarring department will have $4.40 worth of costs already committed to it to properly prepare those peanuts before they can actually be jarred. Moving on to the costs that are added by the second phase of production, the jarring department, we know that the beginning WIP already had for material costs $700 worth of material costs committed to it. And then during the period, we added another $19,000. So that's $19,700 worth of material costs unique to the jarring department, which were added to these cases of peanut butter as we were preparing them. If we divide that by our total equivalent units of production, which we found up above was 39,400, we're going to get our cost per equivalent unit. If we're spending $19,700 and we know that's enough to make 39,400 jars from start to finish, well, that's 50 cents. Just as a reminder right here, that 19,700 is the sum from the first half that we had up here, the total amount of equivalent units of production. It wasn't actually 19,700 because we transferred out some that were, 39,400. We transferred out 38,000 that were fully complete, but the remainder that we had in there were only 20% complete, and that's why we do equivalent units of production. It's just way easier to have one singular number than it is to keep running numbers for different subsets of things that are at different levels of completion. Let's do the same step for conversion costs over here. We've got our beginning WIP, and our beginning WIP had $1,200 worth of conversion costs already committed to it. During the period, we spent $3,840 on labor unique to this department. We allocated $11,000 worth of overhead out of this department's overhead indirect cost pool for a total of $14,840. If I add those two together, that's $16,040 worth of conversion costs that I have to figure out where it's at. Where did they end up? How much of that's going to end up in units which were finished, and how much of that's going to end up in the jarring department's ending WIP? Well, that $16,040 worth of costs went into completing the 38,000 cases that we transferred out, but some of it also went into partially completing, 30% completing, the units that we were working on at the end of the period. And up above, we did the calculations and we found out the total EUP for conversion cost was $40,100. That $16,040 is enough conversion cost to complete 40,100 cases from start to finish. And if you math that out, you divide your total cost to account for by your total equivalent units of production, you determine that the conversion costs that are incurred by the jarring department come out to 40 cents per case. So now on to our total costs. What amount of cost was already committed to beginning WIP? Well, it's $22,000 in transferred in costs plus $700 in material plus $1,200 in conversion costs. That is $23,900 worth of total costs. What got added? The peanut preparation department sent us $176,000 worth of costs, and then the jarring department added $19,000 in materials and $14,840 in conversion. So all in all of these units, which were in the jarring department, had $209,840 worth of costs added to them during the period, not just by our department, but by all phases of production. And you add those two together, and you come up with $233,740. And again, you can math check yourself. This number right here has to be equal to the sum of the two numbers up above it, and also the sum of the row that it's at the end at, and our math checks out. That is $233,740 we got to figure out where it's at. What portion of that are we going to transfer to finished goods, and what portion of that is going to stay here in the jarring department's ending WIP? Well, let's go down and figure out where our costs are going to be accounted for. For completed and transferred out, we're going to take the number of equivalent units of production. We transferred out 38,000 cases. They have to be done for everything, and we know that every completely finished case of peanut butter causes this company to incur $4.40 worth of costs, which are transferred in by the peanut preparation department. So those 38,000 cases of peanut butter at a rate of $4.40 per case means that those cases which were transferred out to finished goods had $167,200 worth of costs put into them by the departments that came before the jarring department in the production process. For our ending WIP at the end of the period, we have 7,000 physical units in ending WIP. Well, all of those units that are in ending WIP in the jarring department still have to be done for all of the things that were transferred in beforehand, or they wouldn't be in the jarring department right now. So you take your number of physical units in ending WIP, you multiply it by $4.40, and you come up with $30,800. So all in all, between the finished peanut butter cases and the cases that we're still working on, we know where $198,000 worth of costs are. And that checks out. That's the total amount of transferred in costs that we had to determine where it was at. And we did. And we know that this portion of it went into units, which we finished. And this portion of it, $30,800, is tied up in units, which are ending WIP for the jarring department. For the direct materials costs that we have over here, the 38,000 cases, which were transferred off to finished goods to be sold, had to be done for all of the costs of the jarring department. Like, they got to be in jars. No one's buying just a big old blob of peanut butter sitting on the shelf. They're done for all of our direct material costs. We determined through our calculations earlier that the process of converting raw peanuts into peanut butter and jarring that peanut butter costs 50 cents in materials for each completed case. 38,000 times 50 cents is $19,000. So that's the amount of completed and transferred out direct material costs that we're going to have. For our units that are an ending WIP, we have 1,400 equivalent units. Yes, there's 7,000 cases in our ending work in process inventory, but they're only 20% done, as we saw earlier in this presentation, which means those 7,000 cases that are 20% done cost the same as 1,400 cases from start to finish. And we now know that completing a case of peanut butter from start to finish costs 50 cents for material. So those 1,400 equivalent units at a rate of 50 cents a piece is $700 worth of material costs that are tied up in units which will be ending WIP for the jarring department at the end of July. And that totals up to $19,700 worth of costs that we have accounted for. And as you can see up here, that math checks out. We have the same total cost to account for that we accounted for. So now we got one more column left, and that column is our conversion cost. For the units which were completed and transferred out, that's 38,000. The units that were transferred off to finished goods have to be complete for all of the machining costs, if you will, that were incurred during the period, both in terms of labor and overhead. We determined through our calculations earlier that the cost per equivalent unit is 40 cents. So each one of those 38,000 cases cost Chewy peanut butter 40 cents to convert from finished raw peanuts into actual jarred peanut butter. 38,000 times 40 cents is $15,200. And we add that to our completed and transferred out column. Then our ending WIP. And the equivalent units and ending WIP for conversion costs is 2,100. Again, we had 7,000 completed units. They're not completed. 7,000 physical jars, excuse me, in ending inventory. But they're not 100% done. They were only 30% done. So completing 7,000 jars 30% of the way costs just as much as completing 2,100 jars the whole entire way. And we know completing a jar or a case of jars the entire way costs 40 cents. So those 2,100 units in ending WIP at a rate of 40 cents a piece is $840. And we throw that into our table, add those two together, and you come up with 16,040. Look up the top to make sure that your costs to account for are equal to your costs accounted for. And they are. So we broke down all of the units that were in the jarring department at the end of the period, and we figured out for each of their three cost components, transferred in costs, direct materials, and conversion costs, what portion of the total costs that we had were in units which we're going to finish and transfer off to finished goods, and what portion of those total costs that we had to account for ended up in units which we're still working on in the jarring department when our business period ends. And in total, we transferred out $167,200 with the transferred in costs, $19,000 with the material costs, and $15,200 with the conversion costs. It's $201,000 worth of costs, which were going to be transferred out of this department, and since we're the final phase of production, and transferred into finished goods inventory. But we are still working on units within the jarring department, and those units that are still a work in process when July ended had $30,800 worth of costs already committed to them by the prior phases of production in our process. And the jarring department had already added $700 in material costs and $840 in conversion costs. You add that up, that's $32,340. So what is our total cost that we've accounted for? Well, $201,400 got completed and transferred out. $32,340 ended up in ending WIP. Add those two together, you get $233,740. And our total costs to account for match our total costs accounted for. And we're very happy about that because that means our production costing report works out. So again, just as a reminder, If you get to the spot on your PCR and those two numbers aren't matching, you've got costs missing somewhere, or if it's the cost accounted for is too high, you got extra costs that should be in there that are in there. Those two numbers have to match at the end, or your report is simply not accurate.